Tainted Eats! With me, Lawrence Gilliard Jr. Okay, so this is gonna be a special edition. This is gonna be a special episode, very dear to me. And I thank you guys for joining me on this one because this one is gonna be dedicated to my late Aunt Chris. Now, real quick about me, my great-grandmother had one daughter. And my grandmother had four daughters. And then my mother, who was the eldest, had me. So I was the first male born into the family. So I could have probably been a little bit spoiled, possibly, but enough about me. My Aunt Chris was the second of the four daughters. And just a little bit about her, she just had a kind heart. She was so generous. She lived life on her own terms. She said what she wanted to, swear words and all. She lived how she wanted to. She was that person in the neighborhood that had an open door policy, so people could literally, like, if I went there, I could just go and walk in. Like, her door was literally open all the time. She fed people in the neighborhood. She would feed the strangers. She would give. She just had the biggest heart. Always, you know, counseling the youth. Just the best. She was the best, and I miss her dearly. So in my family, everyone knows in my family, my mother is like the pancake queen. Every weekend, my mother made pancakes. People would come to our house to get the pancakes. Everyone loves her pancakes. But one time I was at my Aunt Chris's house and my Aunt Chris made pancakes. My Aunt Chris was an amazing cook, by the way. And she goes, "Do you want the plain pancakes or do you want the chocolate chip pancakes?" What? Chocolate chip pancakes? Although my mother was the pancake queen, she never made chocolate chip pancakes. I'd never heard of such a thing. So, of course, I went for the chocolate chip pancakes. And many times I was at my Aunt Chris's house, she made chocolate chip pancakes. So today, I'm going to be making some chocolate chip pancakes to, you know, to honor my Aunt Chris, in memory of my Aunt Chris. And I'm also going to be making some egg muffins to go on the side. So, let's get to making some chocolate chip pancakes. Here are the ingredients that we need for our chocolate chip pancakes. We need, yes, chocolate chips. We need some butter, we need eggs, baking powder, salt, some all-purpose flour, some sugar, and some milk. There it is, all ingredients necessary. Start by sifting 3 cups of all-purpose flour. Now, if your sifter broke like mine did, you can just use a strainer like I did. Taint your flour with 7 teaspoons of baking powder. Taint it with a dash of salt. Mix it up evenly. Add 2 eggs. And then start adding your milk. Now, I don't measure my milk because I like to just stir until I reach a certain consistency. Once I reach a nice, smooth consistency that pours nice and evenly, I know I'm done. Next, taint your batter with 2 tablespoons of sugar. Melt 6 tablespoons of butter and then add it to your batter. Butter to batter. Or just butter, batter, butter, batter, butter, batter. Do it 3 times fast just for fun. A nice tongue twister. And mix it in evenly. Now the fun part. Taint your batter with your chocolate chips. I had an 11-ounce bag of chips and I used about 3/4 of the bag. My Aunt Chris loved her sweets, so I did not use semi-sweet chips. If you can, use a nonstick pan. And here's a tip. If you like the crunchy edges around your pancakes, add a little butter to the pan before you add your batter. If you like smooth edges on your pancakes, just pour the batter right into your nonstick pan without adding the butter. When the batter starts to bubble and get firm on the top, flip it over to the other side. When it's nice and golden on both sides, pick it up and add it to your stack. My Aunt Chris had a very big family, so whenever she cooked, she made things supersized.
That's why I made some pan-sized pancakes. Yum!
Okay, you know what it is. It is story time! So, another thing about my Aunt Chris, along with just being one of the biggest hearted people that I knew, she also had superhuman strength. She wasn't a small woman, she was a big woman, and she had superhuman strength. So I'm gonna tell you guys a story about her superhuman strength. So this story involves me, myself, and at this time I was around 7 years old, and my cousin Ronnie, who was 1 year younger than me, so he must have been about six, and then my sister Corliss was five, and my cousin Nina, who was also five or four, something like that. Probably five. So I was seven, my cousin was six, sister was five, and my other cousin was five. So my Aunt Chris was babysitting us. And at that time we lived on 246 Manhattan Avenue in New York City. And we lived on a sixth floor of a tenement. It was a walk-up tenement. And my aunt was watching us. And of course, as kids, we were running around and we had turned that place into a pigsty. Right? Looked like a tornado hit it. So my aunt needed to go downstairs to the corner store. So she said to us, I'm going to run downstairs really quick to the corner store. I want you guys to straighten up in here a little bit. Can you do that? And me being the eldest, you know, even when I was young, I felt like I had a responsibility, maybe being the first male born. I don't know, but I felt like I had a responsibility. So I'm like, yes, Aunt Chris, we can do it. Right? So my aunt goes downstairs to the store. We started cleaning up the best that we could, and there was a pile of clothes. So we took the pile of clothes and we proceeded to throw them out the sixth story window into the alley. Like in those tenement buildings, like a tenement building next to another tenement building, there was a little alleyway there. And the alleyway was where they kept the garbage cans and stuff. And I saw like the super battling many a rat in that alleyway. We took the clothes, the pile of clothes, and we threw them out the sixth story window into the alley. So my aunt comes back. She looks around. She goes, you guys did an amazing job. Oh my God. Wow. You guys really did. Where'd you put the clothes? And so we're like, over there. We put them right over there. She goes and she looks out the window. And she sees the clothes in the alley and she turns around and she goes, I'm gonna whoop y'all little asses. And so we start running. Everybody scatters. I always, like I said, you know, I thought of myself as pretty smart even at seven. So some went to the closet. Some people went to the kitchen. Some of the kids went to the kitchen. I hid under the bed. After she got everybody else, she came looking for me and she found me under the bed. So I see her legs and I see her at the foot of the bed and she knows at this point I'm under the bed. So she goes around to one side of the bed and she bends down and she swipes the belt and I go to the other side. She misses. She walks around. I follow her to the other side. She swipes the belt and she misses. Then she goes to the foot of the bed and she stops at the foot of the bed. I am not kidding. This is a true story. The entire mattress comes up with one hand. And the belt comes down on me. It was like, I don't know. It was incredible. The mattress came up and I'm staring at her. I couldn't move. And the belt came down and I ran from under the bed. She caught me and she whipped my little ass. That is the story of my Aunt Chris and her superhuman strength. Okay, let's get back to the food.
But before we get back into my kitchen, I wanted to share this quick video of a family barbecue that we had in honor of my Aunt Chris. So I have a pretty big family, and of course at a family barbecue, we're going to have plenty of food, of course, and we're going to have a DJ, of course we need that, and the family showed up. Now of this number, you can probably multiply this by, I don't know, six or seven if you want to talk about my entire family. But of the four daughters, my Aunt Chris added the most in number to the family. She had four children, 18 grandchildren, and 14 great-grandchildren. So she really had herself a big family, and that's why whenever I went to her house, there was plenty of food. no family barbecue is complete until you do at least one line dance.
Family. Family. Hey. Hey. Hey.
Now, let's get back to the meal. These are the ingredients we'll need for our egg muffins. We're going to need an onion, some tomatoes, we're going to need some sweet peppers, some eggs of course, some salt, pepper, mozzarella cheese, some smoked salmon. I like to use this kind, so already smoked and prepared. And we're going to need some basil. Look at my cute basil plant. Core, seed, and chop your peppers. Cut your tomatoes into small pieces. Chop your basil nice and fine. Chop up your onion. And finally, chop up your smoked salmon. Put your eggs in a bowl. I used 8. Tainted with your onions, tainted with some salt, tainted with some pepper, and mix it up evenly. Lightly spray your muffin pan with oil and then fill each cup 3/4 of the way with your egg mixture. For variety, I tainted half of my pan with the tomatoes, basil, and the mozzarella cheese. I tainted the other half of my pan with the peppers and the salmon. But remember, you can taint your eggs with whatever seasonings you like. Into the oven they go at 350. And in about 7 to 10 minutes, voila! Egg muffins. Remove your eggs by gently going around the edges and the bottom with a rubber spatula. I don't know, is it just me or do they look delicious?
All right, here we go. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a few more of these chocolate chips on top, because if you don't know me, I like my sugar. And I'm gonna pour some syrup on there to top that off, not too much. And before I even take a bite, I'm gonna cut into there. Like that. Get myself a nice little bite there. Okay. Here we go. I've got my Aunt Chris's chocolate chip pancakes. And I made some egg muffins to go along with that. Let's try the pancake. Ooh, look at that. Look inside there. You see inside? Look at that gooey yumminess. The gooey yumminess. Let's try. You know, whatever is good as, you know, grandma's or mom's or Aunt Chris's. But it'll do. All right, let me put some egg bite in here, some egg muffin in here. Mm-hmm. This is the salmon one. Look at that. Mmm. That's good. Now we're gonna try this one over here. This is the mozzarella, tomato, and basil one, right there. Yummy too. You know, some people, they taste their food and they're like, it's good, when it's really not, because you know, it's a food show. But so far, it's all been really good. So, thank you guys once again for joining me and joining me for this special episode dedicated to my late Aunt Chris. Thank you, God. Thank you, guys. And I'll see you on the next one. And cut.
Somebody's calling my name.
Hallelujah.
Hush.
Hush.
Somebody's calling my name.
Shall I do?
Oh, okay.
Oh.
no good.
No, huh? No, no,
all right,
no.
Now we